and good morning. It is my great privilege to welcome you all to this glorious event on this glorious day at this glorious place, Pacific Union College. The College on the Hill. Truly, we have all been experiencing a mountaintop experience during these past 2 days. And as we celebrate graduates, this culminating event for our 2011 graduates, we expect an exhilarating yet emotional day as our graduates say goodbye to friends, faculty, and perhaps even to family members. But as they also commence their grand journey into a brave new world of exciting possibilities and, of course, wondrous possibilities. Graduates, these days at PUC have been very special days that will sparkle in your memories for decades to come. Just ask the many PUC alums who are here sitting sprinkled throughout the audience. Today, graduates, you will also join that select group of Americans, just really 30% of Americans, who've worked hard, survived 4 or more years of arduous study, and have therefore earned a college degree. You all embody then the outcomes of that college degree, the combination of intelligence, integrity, and innovation which that degree represents in today's global society. More than this, however, we hope that PUC has changed your lives. No, not just changed your lives, transformed your lives, as you have transformed us here on campus. Through the infinite power of knowledge and the enduring love of the power of God. This, after all, is the outcome of a true Christian education. This morning, I'm also joined as part of the presidential party by our Board of Trustees members. We have 2 members who are with us this morning. If they would stand, Elder Arnold Trujillo and Mrs. Berit Von Pole, please stand. We welcome your presence here as members of our governing board. And we're also joined by members of the PUC administration, if they would stand. Dr. Nancy LaCourte, Vice President of Administration and Academic Dean. Dr. Dave C. Lawrence, CFO. Dr. John Collins, VP for Asset Management. Dr. Lisa Paulson, VP for Student Services. Pam Sadler, Vice President for Advancement. And Julie Lee, Vice President for Marketing and Enrollment Services. It is also an honor, of course, to welcome all of the wonderful family members and friends who have supported our graduates in their quest to achieve their hopes and their dreams. So hold fast to dreams, for if dreams die, life is a broken-winged bird that cannot fly. Hold fast to dreams, for if dreams go, life is a barren field frozen with snow. We thank you for all that you have done and all that you continue to do for PUC and for our precious young people today. Again, welcome.
Our scripture this morning is from Matthew 6:33, and so especially to the class of 2011, but seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you.
Will the audience please stand for the invocation? Oh, holy God, just a few things as we begin this morning. First, for caring and seeing and knowing how great a day of joy and maybe even relief this is for those of us gathered here. Thank you for that. And for degrees and diplomas and completions to come, thank you. And for wisdom too, thank you. And for places like PUC, for this class before you, for all who love and care about them, thank you. And for futures just waiting, thank you. Emmanuel, be with us today, just as you have promised. So let it be. Amen. Thank you for that, so please be seated.
Pastor.
Good morning, PUC.
Good morning.
It is my great privilege here to present our class gift back to PUC, Dr. Knight. This year, we worked really hard. Our class was great. Thank you, class of 2011. And thank you for these officers who worked really hard. Thank you so much for all those burnt fingers making corn dogs for Fall and Spring Fest. Thank you for your help on setting up our booth. Thank you so much for these officers who spent all their time meetings after meetings, planning our banquet. We had some problems with the senior banquet, but thank you so much for the officers hanging in there. We ordered tickets in. Ticketmaster sent us the wrong tickets. After we had handed out half of the tickets, we had to get them back and hand them back out again, like 2 days before the banquet. Thank you so much, everyone, for all your help in letting us work through that. So it is with my great pleasure, on behalf of the class of 2011, to present this check here for the grand total amount of $2,500 and to go towards the Irwin Hall first floor renovation project. We'll be renovating some projects along in conjunction with Senate for a grand total of over $20,000 to go through to those renovations. So Dr. Knight, here you go.
Thank you very much, class of 2011. As we go from good to great on this campus, we're using these monies very, very wisely to make for a very, very good undergraduate learning experience here at PUC. Thank you again for your generosity to PUC.
Hi. Okay. To Dr. Knight, Board of Trustees, esteemed faculty, beloved family and friends, and last but not least, to my fellow graduates from the class of 2011. For most of us, PUC became our first home away from home. And as I fondly look back just 4 short years ago, I recognize that that was just the first of many firsts to come. So how apropos would it be for us to choose Pacific Union College, the home of the pioneers? Merriam-Webster's dictionary defines a pioneer as one who ventures into an unknown territory and also one who opens up new areas of thought, research, or development. To be a pioneer literally means to experience many firsts. I'm sure my fellow graduates and I can still remember moving into our dorm rooms for the very first time and having to share a bathroom with someone who didn't have the same DNA as us. Another first. Some other firsts included finally settling into your dorm room and liking the feeling of being self-sufficient. But with self-sufficiency, we soon realized that unlike being at home, laundry doesn't do itself, and we're often caught scrambling for quarters. Another first was not having to answer to our parents on a daily basis, but then finding out that you actually kind of miss not having them around. Kinda. But then again, some students didn't even experience this first since their mothers insisted on calling every day. Yes, Mom, I'm talking to you. A memorable first for some was meeting their first love. We may not confer as many MRS degrees as Walla Walla and Southern, but we do have a number of students graduating today who have met that one special person whom they're going to spend the rest of their lives with. Our men's basketball team experienced another first when our two very own pioneers, Stephen Catalan and Aaron Reniker, earned the number 1 and 2 spots for our conference's scoring leaders. Loma Linda University ranked the leading institutions from where their medical and dental graduates came from. And we're proud to say that PUC came in second. Yeah, second to none. Last month, our beloved professor, Dr. Tammy McGuire, was voted as Educator of the Year by the student body. This major accomplishment was a first for our communications department. Go 323. And finally, Dr. Heather Knight was the first female president at PUC and is the first African-American woman to lead an Adventist college in the United States. Yes, looking back, seeing all these firsts we experienced, we definitely lived up to the definition of what a true pioneer is. As much as PUC has equipped us to be leaders, to be pioneers, history has proven that a true leader must also learn to be a great follower. But we certainly cannot and must not just follow anybody. And for that matter, we shouldn't even follow what we may think is best. Because the greatest book ever written tells us to trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding, but in all your ways, acknowledge him and he will guide your paths. As graduates, we had the honor of being taught by some of the finest educators. But with that being said, we, the class of 2011, must reflect and rely on the greatest mentor and guide, Christ. At PUC, we've had many memorable firsts, but as we leave our soon-to-be alma mater behind, the legacy of this class will remain at PUC. As our enrollment department continues to work hard and recruit new students, an increasing number of freshmen will soon be experiencing many of their own firsts. And I am confident that the caliber of this graduating class will surely not be PUC's last. So to my fellow graduates, our challenge is to continually strive to be pioneers and followers of Christ to whoever our next first may be. May God bless PUC, and may God bless the class of 2011.
Now for our commencement address. Thank you. Pastor Ikki Tolu Taimi was born in Tonga in 1976. In 1981, his family arrived in the United States of America and finally settled in Southern California. Pastor Taimi recalls that his hard-working immigrant parents worked many, many hours to take care of their children and to give them a Christian education. And though through the family trade of gardening, and so like our very first parents in the Garden of Eden, Adam and Eve, they learned to love to tend gardens and to create beautiful landscapes. A graduate of Monterey Bay Academy, Pastor Taimi attended PUC for his very first year of college before transferring to La Sierra University. Sorry, Pastor Taimi. To complete a major in biblical studies and a minor in biblical languages. And he's currently also pursuing his master's degree, by the way, at La Sierra. We'll forgive him. Pastor Taimi, however, currently pastors the Genesis Church in Gardena, and he also serves as director for campus ministries on secular campuses, such as USC and other colleges in the Los Angeles area. He's also the chair of the President's Cabinet of Young Adult Ministries, where he's enjoying heeding God's voice in a number of innovative ministries for young people. A newlywed of just 8 months, Pastor Taimi proclaims that he loves food, people, and most of all, he loves God. Please welcome our commencement speaker for 2011, Pastor Ikki Taimi.
PUC! Tortillas just aren't a form of sustenance around here. It's equipment of death. Thank you, President, for that very warm welcome and for putting me on blast. You could have just finished that PUC. That was good. It is good to be here among you today. Graduates of 2011. Tortilla hailers, you have made it. You made it. You got through it. Here we sit today. You look pretty and you smell good because you made it. You went through the classes you had to take. And you took some classes that you loved and there are other classes you just didn't care for. But you did it. You're here today for a reason. Because you have survived your undergraduate experience. You got through your difficulties. You've made it through some relationships, some great relationships, and some bad relationships. You've met some great teachers, and you've ignored others. You were in this place of process while the world was in turmoil. Earthquakes, tsunamis, devastation, Charlie Sheen. You made it. And here you are today, my friends. I want to just talk a little bit today about your next few decisions. This is a pretty awesome event that we get to be at. It is a privilege and an honor to be here and to share with you. And I thought, what better way to share this moment and this experience by just talking about Jesus for a little bit. Is that okay? It's my default. It's one of my problems. It's one of my faults. I'm a minister, and so I love to talk about Christ. And so today, I want to just share a little bit from the book of Matthew. Pray with me. God, thank you so much for who you are. In spite of us, Father, you continue to bless. There were many here, Lord, who've been on a long road. And here they stand today, ready to move forward. So I ask, Father, that you continue to bless them in all they do. Speak to us now. I pray this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Some of you had to shed blood and tears to be here. Others of you, strict motivation and will. Still, others of you are sitting here because, well, you just literally wore PUC out. And they couldn't hold you any longer. But for whatever reason, you're here today. And at this wonderful event, I want to look at another event that was happening a few thousand, couple thousand years ago. And we find this wonderful event in the book of Matthew. The book of Matthew, chapter 6. Jesus says this, "Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you'll eat or drink, about your body or what you will wear. Is not life more important than food and body more important than clothes? Look at the birds of the air. They don't sow or reap or store away in barns, and yet their heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much more valuable than they? Who of you, by worrying, can add a single hour to his life? And why do you worry about clothes? See how the lilies of the field grow. They do not labor or spin. Yet I tell you that not even Solomon in all his splendor was dressed like one of these. If that is how God clothes the grass of the field, which is here today and tomorrow is thrown into the fire, will he not much more clothe you, you of little faith? So, do not worry, saying, what shall we wear? What shall we drink? Or what shall we eat? For the pagans run after these things, and your heavenly Father knows you need them. But seek first the kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given unto you. But seek first the kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you." The Galilean takes a moment to assess the situation, and he sees that an event is brewing. And at events, those are the best times for you and I to begin to evaluate things. When we come to milestones in our life, those are the places in which we begin to evaluate. And so, graduates, I need you to evaluate, because this is a milestone. We do it at birthdays and New Year's. We do them at anniversaries, and we do them at graduations. What evaluations do we take at New Year's? What do people say in New Year's? Resolutions, right? What happened last year? What am I going to do better this year? What's the number one resolution everybody gives? I'm going to lose weight. And you never do. I, I dislike it when I see skinny people say that, right? I'm so fat. I'm gonna lose like 70 pounds. You weigh 60 pounds. You can't do that. We assess and we evaluate. This is a time for you to assess and evaluate what you've been through. This last 3 years that you may have transferred here, 2 years, 4 years that you've been here, 7 years to get that degree. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
It's a time for you to evaluate, my friends. I'm going to ask you a couple evaluation questions, and I want you just for a few seconds to answer true or false in your head. Don't share this out loud. It could get awkward. True or false? Are you happy with yourself? Are you happy with your relationships? Are you content with what you've done? Are you where you want to be in life? Do you feel as if you have everything you need to create contentment? Are you feeling spiritually fulfilled? Is your relationship with God consistent? Are you where you want to be? Do you have passion? And do you have purpose? Jesus stops with these disciples on the side of a mountain as he sees the crowd pouring in. Mediterranean peasants, agrarians, philosophers, teachers of the law, Pharisees, Sadducees. And as they pull together, he notices this great event happening. And so he begins to allow them to evaluate where they were, where they have come from, so that they can choose where they want to go. I want you to choose where you would like to move in your life. In order to do that, you must evaluate. Some Christians use this bit of scripture to discuss how we should never worry. We talk about, oh, you know, see, this bit of scripture here tells us we should never worry. And if you're worrying, you just don't have enough faith. You've just got to have more faith so that you don't worry. And that's just not right. But I don't think that's where this piece of scripture is going. I don't think that's what Jesus was leading us to when he was talking about this. In fact, all of us have worried. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
I know you worried. Because you left home 4, 2, or 7 years ago to go to college. And you told your parents, I am independent. Get off my back. And then you had to call them a week later to borrow some money. This is your independent son calling. Can I borrow $10? Right? I know you worry because you had to get those courses done. You had to finish reports. You have relationship issues. Relationships causes us to worry. I've been married a little more than 8 months. You worry. It's part of life. And so the answer is not to stop worrying and to be naive or to shelter everyone from the stresses of worry. I don't think that's what Jesus was talking about. He was building a fresh idea in their minds. He was giving them some theology that would turn into an ideological lifestyle. It's not that worrying is the problem. It's what we're consistently worrying about. The problem is when you and I begin to focus in and we begin to worry about one particular thing, that's what becomes our drive for life. If you show me a person's greatest worries and anxiety issues and his fears or her fears, I can show you his or her God. Because whatever it is that we worry about, that is what we focus on. That is what comes to our forefront. That's what we think about at night. That's what we want to live to do. Those are the things that begin to cloud our life. And so Jesus is telling you and I, what are you worried about? What is the greatest worry? And don't fret on those things. The clothes that we wear, the food that we eat, the all these things that you and I freak out about. That's what we begin to focus our lives on. There are some people who love to worry about clothes. What kind of clothes we wear. There's some people who like to really worry about where I'm going to get a job after this. How many of you know what you're going to do after graduation? Right? Some of you. The rest of you are thinking about changing your name so that financial aid can't find you. Right? There are things that we constantly worry about. Position, title, this relationship. I've really got to make my person in my life happy, and I've got to meet all of her needs, and if I don't, she's going to leave me, or he's just not going to love me if I don't do all of this. And so we're constantly worrying about all these things, and the problem is not that we worry about them, but that we worry so much that that's all we focus on. And so what we begin to do when we focus in on that is we begin to raise it up to the top, and no longer do we focus in on God and his righteousness and the works of his kingdom and what he wants for us, but we're constantly thinking about this. I've got to get that job. I've got to keep this relationship moving. I've got to have the right clothes. Clothes, really? There are people in this world who all they worry about is the clothes they wear or the team that they root on. And when the Lakers lose, are you cheering for the Lakers or because they lost? You hurt my feelings. We go about our teams, you know. I see these grown men wearing people's jerseys. I don't understand wearing people's jerseys. I don't get that process. Because I'm a huge Lakers fan, you know, diehard. But you'd never see me wearing a Kobe jersey. You know what? I would never wear a jersey with another man's name on it. It's not my thing. Yeah, man. Kobe Bryant. We spend our lives worrying about these knickknacks. And we think that these are the important things of life. That we would have a position, that we would have the right set of clothes, that we would have a bank account, that we would make everyone in our lives happy. And so we go about trying to fill all of these cups. And at the end of the day, we're left wanting. And God is saying, it's not that I don't want you to worry about these things. It's that I need your focus and your attention to be on me. I need you to focus back in. Come back to me. Be part of the movements that I'm calling to you. And when you get into that purpose and when you get into that place, then you begin to find the peace that passes all understanding. Then you begin to find the passion. Then you begin to find the purpose that you've been looking for. And no matter what kind of car you drive or what kind of a bank account you have or what kind of title is behind or before your name and what kind of relationship you're in, you're finding that God's peace is beginning to lead your life. So I ask you, what is it that you worry about? I'm just going to share a little bit from the book of Matthew, verse 33. Listen to this. But seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given unto you as well. Seek first his kingdom and his righteousness. I'm going to stop at one word and one word alone in this verse. That's the word seek. I love the word seek. I want everybody to say seek.
Seek.
Awesome. I love languages. This is one of the reasons why I got into theology, because I loved the idea of learning languages. It's been a part of my life. I grew up in California. I was born in Tonga, but I grew up in California. And if you live in California, you're automatically bilingual, right? Especially in Southern California. Everyone speaks Spanish in Southern California. It doesn't matter who you are. It doesn't matter. You're Korean, you're Asian, you're black. You're Tongan, you speak Spanish. And you know, you don't speak a lot of it, you just speak a little bit, just enough to know that you can do it, right? You can say words like they're supposed to be said, like, hola. ¿Dónde está el baño? Right? People get impressed. Oh, hola, hola. And you're like, oh, no, hola. That's all I got for you, right? So if you live in California, you have this, you know, fascination. And as growing up here, I'm Tongan, so my first language isn't English. It's Tongan. And I had to learn English, which, by the way, English is the hardest language in the world. We have to teach it to everybody until they die because English is difficult. I don't understand why we have so many words for one thing. Right? Like, we should all get together. I don't know, English department, get together. Call together the American Association of Speaking English People. And decide to just give something one name as opposed to like a thousand names. Like you have the name sandal or thong or slipper or, you know, and I'm like, why? What? Just one word. You know, in our language, in Tongan, it's called supapa. Everybody say supapa. Supapa. Why? Because it's a su, which is a shoe, And when you walk, it goes like this. Ba, ba, ba. Hence, soup, ba, ba. Didn't make sense, right? Language is something that I truly love. It's something that for me is, you know, I've always been into it. I'll teach you another Tongan word. It's called hina. Everybody say hina. Okay, that means bottle. Now say hina. Okay, that means spider. Now say hina, hina. That means white. You've just learned half of our vocabulary with one word, right? So we were talking, you have to find it in context. Oh, hina. Oh, he's getting the bottle. Oh, hina. Oh, the spider. Hina, hina. Oh, white. Right? That's how we do it. Language has always been something that's been dear to me. And so as I looked up through this verse, I stopped at Matthew chapter 6, verse 33, because to me, I thought it was pretty amazing. So the word seek comes to me, and I'm checking this word out, and I'm looking at it, and the word seek in Greek is zetera. So everybody say zetera. Oh, good, good. And it means seek. That's what it means. Surprised? No. Because the word means seek. But here's what's impressive to me. When you parse the word, it is present, active, imperative. So, graduates, present tense means what? It means it's happening now, right? It's not past tense or future tense. Past tense would be sought. Future tense is I will seek. But it's present tense to seek. It's active, which means what? Who's doing the action? You are. Right? I'm doing the action. The action's not being done unto me. I do the action. It's an active state. So I will seek. I seek. Okay. And it's imperative. So the imperative tense means it's a command. Like Jesus is telling you, this is it. You've got to do it. And so I'm just going to talk on those three little things and let you go do about whatever it is you got to do for the rest of today. You can invite me over to have lunch later. Thank you. Present tense. That means right now. It's always in the context of right now. Not later, not before, right now. I do it now. That means to seek tomorrow is the same as it means today as you're sitting here. So on Monday, when everyone else is gone and you're counting money, Jesus is telling you, seek. On Tuesday, when you've got to leave your significant other because they're going to another graduate school and you're not, it still means to seek. On Wednesday, when financial aid calls you and says, if you want your real diploma, you got to pay the rest of the $5 you owe us. It still means seek. It's present tense. God is saying something to you and I, that every day you and I must live a present tense seeking of God. That we've got to seek his kingdom every single day. Above all other things. Above seeking out what your job's going to be. Above seeking out your relationships. Above seeking out your position and your clothing. It's about seeking God every single day. As denominational people, we're good at seeking God at least once a week. We're called Seventh-day Adventists. And so we seek God on the seventh day. We're event-oriented. And we go to church, and then when we're done with church, we're done. But if the music isn't just right, or if the pastor just isn't hot enough with his sermon or her sermon, then we say, oh, I just don't have a good experience at church today. If the pastor was good, or if you're someplace you're like, woo, I'm spiritually blessed, praise the Lord. And we live our lives like this. We wait for an event to pump us up. But Jesus says this, every day you must have a present tense seeking of me. Every day. My wife and I got married. Yeah, it's a good thing. Marriage is good. You should try it sometime. My wife and I got married, and then we began to grow together. We grew together. Like, literally, we started to grow physically. My wife is one of those people who she can eat whatever she wants. I don't know if you have a friend like that. My wife is that person who eats whatever she wants and loses weight. So when we go out and eat, I'll watch her eat and then I'll gain like 5 pounds of it. And this is my wife. And so we began to grow together. And one day she says, ick, you're looking kind of healthy. I said, I know what that means. Cut me deep, sister. She says, let's start exercising. Let's start working out. I said, we just got married. Calm down. Exercise. Right? She says, come on. All right, let's do it. What are we gonna do? Let's do P90X. Right? I went from doing nothing and eating to P90X. I said, no, that's not gonna happen. She says, we'll just do the yoga part. The yoga. It's easy. Yoga's easy. Yoga's not easy. I'm a grown man, and I'm proud to say yoga's not easy. We started doing that yoga business, holding positions that the Lord didn't make us to hold. Standing for what seemed like hours on out. Pain, sweat. I thought I was beginning to lose my memory. I said, honey, we gotta stop. Just turn the video off. This is just way too much. He's just so intense. We've been going on for hours now. And then Tony Horton says, all right, now that we're done with the warm-up. You're not serious, Tony. Get done with it. The next day I wake up, my body is in pain from yoga, right? Parts that I hadn't moved in a while. But with that pain, I felt strong. I felt like I did something. I got up that morning and I took my shirt off. I walked around the house, my chest out, and my wife said, Ick, you need to work out some more. I said, honey, but I can feel it working. That was the last time we worked out. That feeling that felt good, that burn that felt great, the muscles that began to take place ended because that was an event. It wasn't an everyday seeking. My friends, you can't wait for a good praise set. You can't just wait for a minister to pray for you. You can't wait for a milestone or for some tragedy to happen in your life. Jesus is saying this, present tense, seek me every day. Every day. Imperative. It means to be purposeful. It's not a suggestion. It means that it is a required course. Jesus didn't give this as a suggestion to his friends. He didn't say, oh, if you need to, you could seek me out. Or when you're going through tough times, seek me out. Or, you know, when you're happy and you have a little extra money, seek me out and give me some of that money. Jesus said this in an imperative tense, which means he's telling you, you got to seek me. In life, as in school, there are two kinds of courses. There's the required courses, and then there is there's the elective courses. Just like school, that's how life works. There are required courses. What are some required courses? Well, being birthed is a required course. You and I don't have any say in it. It just happens, and that's how we get here. We can't choose where we were birthed. We can't choose who births us. We can't choose any of that. Birth just happens. You and I are here. What's another one? Relatives. That's a required course. You have to be related to the people you're related to. You can't choose. You can lie, but you can't choose, right? You have crazy relatives, some distant relatives, you know, that you never invite to things, but they always show up, probably here in the back somewhere looking for you. Crazy relatives that you're related to. Even crazier, some of you, it's not even your distant relatives, it's like your immediate family, like your parents or your siblings, and you know they're here for you. Right? They hide things they're going to bring here because they want to make some noise when you get up. Your mom may have started putting some pots and pans in her purse. When Sally gets up, everyone just grab a pot and pan. Just ding, 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 ding. Right? As my brother showed up to my graduation like that. He brought my pots and pans and walked out of there as if it was normal, right? Like, what's up, man? Yeah, it's my pots and pans. They make this crazy noise, and when they see you, they just, oh, we love you! And you're like, oh, you're so embarrassing. And some of you are still trying to figure out who these family members that are crazy, because it's you. That's a required course. Another required course is death, growing old. It's another required course. No matter what you do, how many creams you use, how much exercise you want to do, any yoga position you got, you're going to grow old. And as much as you try one day, you're going to look in the mirror and say, where is all my hair? It's gone. But then there are elective courses. Those are things you get to choose. Where I'm going to live, what I'm going to do, so on. Jesus says this about seeking him. This is an imperative course. It's something that you shouldn't even try to think about. It is something that you should do every day. And finally, to seek is active. This is you doing the action. This is you making choices. This is about you moving forward. My friends, no one can seek God for you. No one can make those decisions for your life. Only you can. And when you leave this place, whether you have a lot of money or whether you owe a lot of money, when you leave this place and you're looking for your job, when you leave this place and you've picked up all the tortillas so that you can have a meal for the next 9 months, when the torment of life hits you and your relationship goes crashing down, when another economic, financial travesty happens, you have the choice. Are you willing to actively seek God in your life? If you do, you will find the peace that passes all understanding. And only then will you find success. God bless you, my tortilla throwers. May the Lord go with you wherever you go. And if I could, I'd just love to say a quick prayer for you guys in this place. Just real quick. God, thank you so much for walking with them in life. Thank you for blessing them, Lord, with your presence, your guidance, and your wisdom. As they move on into the next tier, as they move on to the next platform, as they move on to the next joyous occasions and painful events, I pray, Father, that they take you with them. Wherever they go, Lord, that they seek you out first and foremost, that they don't wait for an event to happen, but that they seek you every day, that it's a present tense in their life. Whether they have a great job and they've been picked up to lead, or whether they're humble gardeners who take care of landscape, wherever their direction, whether they find the perfect mate to live the rest of their life with, or whether they find themselves alone, may they seek you first. Bless them, Lord, as they go into this world and as you begin to order their life. I pray this in the name of Jesus Christ and all God's people. Say it.
Amen.
God bless you guys.
Good morning. Before I present the class of 2011, I want to introduce our new Educator of the Year, chosen this spring by our student body, Associate Professor of Communication, Dr. Tammy McGuire. Dr. McGuire teaches her courses with energy, humor, and a keen intelligence. She is known as a dynamic speaker, a careful researcher, and an amazing athlete. It is with great affection that we present this award to Dr. Tammy McGuire. And now, I am proud to address the 123rd graduating class of Pacific Union College. 314 graduates, receiving 95 associate degrees, 230 bachelor's degrees, and one master's degree. As usual, nursing is the largest group among you, with a total of 120 degrees to be awarded. Nine of you have completed the requirements of the honors program. The gold, white, and blue cords you are wearing represent the integration of sciences, humanities, and the arts. Many of you have already been accepted to prestigious institutions to continue your studies in business, psychology, medicine, law, English, history, dentistry, religion, and many other fields. Others of you are already working as nurses and teachers and managers. We are proud of each one of you and look forward to hearing of your achievements in the future. Congratulations to you all. Will the candidates please stand? President Knight, it is with pleasure and confidence that I, on behalf of the faculty, present these candidates of the class of 2011 to you for the conferral of their degrees.
Upon the recommendation of the faculty of Pacific Union College, and with the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of Pacific Union College and the State of California, I now confer upon these candidates who have successfully completed requirements for graduation their respective diplomas and degrees.
Please sit down. Presenting the senior class officers. President, graduating with a Bachelor of Science in Public Relations Journalism, cum laude, Taylor Ashley Koumoupas. Executive Vice President, graduating with a Bachelor of Science in Chemistry, cum laude, Raimundo Romero. Social Vice President, graduating with a Bachelor of Science in Business Administration, Byron Chang Han Liu. Secretary, graduating with a Bachelor of Arts in History with an emphasis in American history and a Bachelor of Science in Communication with honors, Christina Marie Alba. Chief Financial Officer, graduating with a Bachelor of Business Administration with an emphasis in accounting, summa cum laude, Li Lily Guan. Religious Vice President, graduating with a Bachelor of Arts in Religion with an emphasis in health professions, magna cum laude, Alicia Nicole Teferi. Yeah! Sergeant at Arms and current Student Association President, graduating with a Bachelor of Science in Biology, Wari Ferrer Lyon. public relations officer, graduating with a Bachelor of Science in Graphic Design with an emphasis in design, Stephanie Nicole Ward. Historian, graduating with a Bachelor of Science in both Graphic Design with an emphasis in design and photography, magna cum laude, fourth generation PUC graduate, Lonnie Anna Johnston. Candidates for the degree Associate of Science, Deanna J. Brown. Jennifer Claudio. Sarah Jean Montez Helms. Graduating cum laude, Adam Lowe. Annabelle Joan Aquino Mendaros. Nathan Gregory Miller. Amanda Ray Pena. Recipient of the Sheriff Doug Cofford Medal from the Napa County Sheriff's Office for service above and beyond, Scott Ronald Roberts. Eric Nicholas Salazar. Benjamin J. Toledo. Candidates for the degree Associate of Science in Nursing. Isaac Awar Anjejo. Claudia Balderas. Krista Noel Ballou. Grant Anton Benson. Jill Kathleen Bergman. Michaela Dawn Brown. Jericho Bryan. Shayla Diane Burkhart. Jacqueline Nicole Canavasio. Anna Marie Mendoza Carrillo. Drew Culp. Colin Davis. Marshall Dillon. Patrick Gallardo. Edward Ruiz Deluz. Graduating cum laude, Jonathan Groeschel. Kaylin Victoria Hamada. Sean Patrick Hayes. Laura Marina Hernandez. Esmeralda Gornell Cosmero. Graduating magna cum laude, Sarah Elizabeth Leone. Melissa Liao. Whitney Cynthia Lerungan. Joyce Kelly Maglalung. Michael Joseph Delisai Magpayo. Graduating cum laude, Erica May Ashley Nicholas Marquez. Graduating cum laude, Sarah Lynn Aquino Mendaros. Juliet Mua. Shauna Newport. Benjamin Néré Noir-Jean. Joanne Park. Jordan Augustine Patricio. Rachel Ann Rabara Rosas. Rebbe Mary Lou B. Sakai. Megan Catherine Safaloff. Angelia Sarsoza. Christina Ann Shade. Mercedes Seau. Nicholas A. Shepherd. Asima Sinaga. Chris Christy Singenstrew. Marissa Hope Smith. Kelly Song. Andrew Fabian Talon. Andrew Tan Tirado. Kaylee Turk. Graduating cum laude, Justine Bianca Nava Ubaldo. Angelina Caramucci Vasquez. Jason De Los Santos Velez. Kayla Erica Bacani Violanda, graduating cum laude. Matthew Lang Voss. Graduating cum laude, Pamela Renee Warwick. Justin E. Zamora. Jillian Noel Zagara. Elias Cermeño. Candidates for the degree Bachelor of Arts. Jose Antonio Baltodano. Zelina Cervantes. Graduating magna cum laude, Jennifer Yu-Ung Cho. Christina Cruz. Britton A. Dake. Crystal Kathleen Davis Small. Jerry Duncan. Graduating magna cum laude, Christopher James Feldbusch. Graduating with a Bachelor of Arts in both Business Administration and Religion with an emphasis in Biblical Studies, Eric Daniel Galang. Nathaniel Thomas Garcia. Alex J. Hardman. Graduating with a Bachelor of Arts in both English with an emphasis in British and American literature and history with an emphasis in European history, summa cum laude, Tava Miles Helly. graduating with honors, cum laude, Shayna Roxanne Herman. Graduating magna cum laude, Mia Zoe Jeannou. Anthony Lionel Leslie. Harrison Frank Mullen. Graduating cum laude, Erinne Gein Nakamura. Robert Michael Negretti. Jonathan Alexander Osorio. Adam Alexander Pena. Julove Andy Pierre. Graduating cum laude, Nicole E. Pizak. Thomas Lyndon Salisbury. Graduating with a Bachelor of Arts in both Spanish and Theology, with honors, summa cum laude, fourth generation PUC graduate, Jillian Lee Spencer. Michael Ryan Toledo. Jessica Alexandra Toy. Graduating with a Bachelor of Arts in both Chemistry and Spanish, summa cum laude, Kirsten Ellis Nicole Vance. Graduating with a Bachelor of Arts in both International Communication with an emphasis in French and French, Naomi Vivian Washington. Graduating cum laude, Brent Arwin Wild. Graduating cum laude, Kylie Young. Candidates for the degree Bachelor of Business Administration. Graduating cum laude, Benjamin J. Canther. Graduating cum laude, Michaele William Cruz. Alexandria Nicole Evans. Heather Victoria Jacobson. Katrina Lucas. Alexandra Nicole Swart. Yeah. Bradley Todd Taves. Raymond Vasmoot. Crisol Villaseñor. Daniel Zerkic. Candidates for the degree Bachelor of Music, graduating cum laude, Linda K. Marks. Graduating cum laude, Heidi Lynn Rasmussen. Candidates for the degree Bachelor of Science. Graduating summa cum laude, Christine Misako Akamini. Graduating cum laude, Claire Arakaki. Graduating cum laude, Lauren Ask. Graduating magna cum laude, Amanda Gale Baker. Jordan Vargas. Jonathan Edward Barrett. Graduating cum laude, Sameh Alfi Rushdie Bekit. Mario Moises Benitez Cifuentes. Graduating cum laude, fourth generation PUC graduate, Lisa Ray Bobst. Scott David Brizendine. Graduating cum laude, Rachel E. Bush. Oliver Corey Charles Jr. Stephanie Chaviano. Graduating with honors, magna cum laude, Annalisa Michelle Christensen. Graduating cum laude, Caitlin Elise Christensen. Michael Joseph Comazzi.
Get a picture. There we go.
Carrie Cordes. Lisa Diane Davison. Vincent Samuel Dorrington. Graduating cum laude, Julietta Farmer-Whiteside. Caitlin Caroline Frank. Heidi Ann Frick. Jacob Phineas Friday. Graduating with both an Associate of Science and a Bachelor of Science in Early Childhood Education, Catherine Amelia Elizabeth Friesen. Zachary John Gately. Trevor Gomes. Benjamin A. Gonzalez. Bianca Francis Gonzalez. Stephen Michael Grove. Kaylani Lorene Hagelgatz, cum laude. Graduating with honors, Laurel Ann Hansen. Tara Ruth Henriksen. Eric Michael Hyung. Graduating magna cum laude, Laura Ann Jacobson. Charles Isaac Johnson. Ashley Jones. Graduating cum laude, Rochelle J. Kim. William D. Kim. Graduating with a Bachelor of Science in both graphic design with an emphasis in design and photography, magna cum laude with honors, Diana Klonek. Elise Noelle Knutson. Gary Kuo. Graduating cum laude, Eugenia Yujin Kwan. Graduating summa cum laude, Carrie Jasmine Lam. Graduating with honors, magna cum laude, Fabienne Olivia Leaf. Anthony Suhan Lee. Graduating magna cum laude, Anthony Wei-En Lee. Yeah. graduating with a Bachelor of Science in both Computer Science and Film and Television, Stephen Hunter Lutz. Graduating summa cum laude, Andrew Mai. Walter Jonathan Morrowquin. Graduating summa cum laude, Joshua Rajan Masalamani. Graduating with a Bachelor of Science in both Graphic Design with an emphasis in design and photography, Carrie Lynn Moore. Sanjay Samuel Moses. Sonia Rachel Moses. Gabriel Serafine Navarro. Aranyani Notstein. Samantha Esther Owens. Bruce Jefferson Packey. Pierce Edward Fitzner. Graduating magna cum laude, Nicholas T. Pittenger.
Thank you.
Lawrence Scott Presley. Brennan Anthony Puya. Melissa Juliana Rajaguguk. Graduating summa cum laude, Aaron Scott Reneker. Nicole Diane Schmidt. Chelsea Elizabeth Schroeder. Eric Jason Silvas. Samantha Ann Singh. Seth Douglas Sumaraga. Christopher R. Lopez Tyna. Esther Yuri Tak. Graduating with honors, summa cum laude, Zoe Alana Louise Thompson. Yeah. Graduating summa cum laude, Jonathan J. Uniat. Andrea Valadez. Lauren Elise Wakoff. Darren Lloyd West. Melissa Renee Wilson. Randall Trent Zumalt. Candidates for the degree Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Gil Michael A. Abba. Roselle Salazar Abarelio. Miriam Bogala Anulo. Kelly Elaine Baker. Graduating cum laude, Corbin Bossi. Beth Bowman. Graduating magna cum laude, Krista Jeanette Briano. The next candidate is graduating in absentia. He was deployed to Afghanistan last Wednesday. Technical Sergeant Ernesto A. Brizuela. Janelle Priyangika Dias. Graduating magna cum laude, John Stephen Ferris. Jacqueline Julia Georgiana Frank. Amanda Michelle Grube. Chelsea Marie Hawkinson. Samuel Wayara. Hala Kabas. Sarah Kahelelani Hatsue Kuma. Alisa Colleen Lopez. Lori John McKenzie. Deirdre Soriban Madrid.
Go at 'em, baby!
Robin J. Manolovitz. Taisha McFarland. Graduating cum laude, Justin Duncan Pope. Thomas Albert Rangel, Jr. Roxanne Renshaw. Kristen Nicole Straw. Shelley Ray Teske. Paul Daniel Wheeler. Suzette L. Wheeler. Graduating cum laude, Lisa Frances Zuhl. Candidates for the degree Bachelor of Social Work, Jennifer Ariza. Patricia Barragan Navarro. Alberto Gabriel Benitez. Melissa Sue Calderon. Nadia Elise Chukimia. Lynette M. Domer. Ana Karen Hernandez Gaona. Graduating with both a Bachelor of Social Work and a Bachelor of Arts in Spanish, cum laude, Cristina Inostroza. Kate Osenya. Vrenny S. Palacios. Brian Rodriguez. The next set of degrees goes to a very special group of students, the adults of our degree completion program. These men and women have successfully balanced the demands of home, family, work, and study to complete bachelor's degrees. They and their families deserve extra recognition this morning for this achievement. Audrey Lynn Montgomery. I'm sorry. I knew I was going to do that. Candidates for the degree Bachelor of Science in Early Childhood Education, graduating magna cum laude, Dorothy P. Floro. Yeah. Graduating cum laude, Jessica Lorraine Garcia. Victoria K. Garrison. Siva Ann Jumeli. Kimberly Ilya. Morgan Alexis Knight. Graduating cum laude, Kimberly Lambert. Audrey Lynn Montgomery. Graduating summa cum laude, Rosario De Lucia Morris. Connie Ann Parangan Assertion. Graduating cum laude, Christina K. Evoy Phillips. Carolyn Mary Sanders. Graduating magna cum laude, Sharon C. White. Caroline Barkmeyer Womack. Candidates for the degree Bachelor of Science in Management, Jamie A. Bauer. Maria Concepcion Perez de Bautista. Nicole Descanier. Graduating cum laude, Joy Marion Ellard. Kelly Furia. Nikita Zamora Isaac. Beth Ann Jenkins. Harold Norman Jones. Beth Ann Camaloni. Tanya Yvonne Camaloni. Maretta Mae King. Esther Melgar. Graduating cum laude, Sarah Ann Pierce. Patty Voss. Candidate for the degree Master of Education. Joining me to hood the candidate is Tom Lee, Chair of the Department of Education. Graduating cum laude, Anna Felena Strange. Anna's master's project is entitled Concept Imagery Enhancing Comprehension, Methods for Teaching Students to Visualize While Reading. Let's congratulate the recipient of our highest degree.
Class of 2011, Today you join an elite group, the Pacific Union College Alumni Association. From this day forward, whenever someone says, "Our college on the mountain," your heart will warm. And you'll start salivating when someone mentions Juni Juice. And when you hear the phrase, "the grind," you'll conjure up something different in your mind than most of the world. And Reneker and Catalan will always make you think of basketball. And someday, some of you will sit in this very commencement grove and watch your children graduate. In fact, as evidence of that, could I ask all the graduates of Pacific Union College to stand today in support of our newest alumni? Please stand, wherever you are. Thank you. Class of 2011, go well. But wherever you go, know that you are loved and you always have a home at Pacific Union College. Congratulations.
I would like to ask you to please stand for the benediction, and after the benediction, we would invite everyone except the graduates to please be seated for the recessional. Let us pray. Father in heaven, we thank you so much for your goodness and your grace. What a joyous day this is. We celebrate with the young people who have graduated, Father, and their parents, their loved ones. We also want to commend, Father, in a very special way and ask for a blessing on our administration, our faculty, our staff, our parents and supporters. Father, please bless. Bless us as we leave this mountaintop, but never, Father, your presence. For we pray in Jesus' name, amen. Thank you.